In the previous part of the video, we saw what exactly is a fragile class problem and how to solve them. Now, in this video, we'll talk about how .NET framework handles automatically some of the fragile class issues. So, in order to understand the same, you know, what I've done is you can see that I have created two classes here. One is the parent class and the other one is a child class. And this child class actually inherits from the parent class. And in the child class, I have created a very simple method here called as handle numerics, and it takes a double data type. Okay. Now, further down below, in my static void main, I'm creating the child class and I'm passing him the a data which is an integer data type. So you can see here I'm actually, you know, setting 100 to an integer value here, and I'm actually passing this integer data type to handle numerics. So if I run this application over here, so if I go and run this console application, so it goes here, it goes to handle numerics, and it actually goes to this method here, handle numerics, and it displays that displays child numeric over here. Okay. Now, for now, let's assume that this child class is used in a lot of places. So probably it is not only used in this console application over here, but probably it has been used by some ASP.NET application. It is probably used by some MVC application. Probably it has been deployed in a lot of client places. Now, let's say after 2-3 months of deployment, the parent class developers, they go and add a new method here called as handle numerics. Okay, so they go and add probably a virtual method here called as handle numerics, and they make this data type as integer. Okay. So the parent class developers, you know, without consulting with the child class developers, they go and, you know, implement, or they go and add a new method here called as handle numerics, which actually, you know, handles numeric data type. So I'll say that this is parent numeric handling. Now, this small change in the parent class is actually not a small change. It is a very, very big change. Why? Because this parent class has been inherited by the child class. So whatever change you make in this parent class will have cascading effects on the child class. And following, because the child class, you know, has been installed in a lot of locations, you know, those clients will start having problems. So for example, in this case, if you see our client here, that means if you see the static void main here, if you see this child class object now, it has two overloaded methods, right? One is this method which has a double data type which is created by the child class, and the other one which is the integer data type, this one which is created by the parent class. So now if you apply method overloading fundamentals, what should happen is, because you are passing an integer value, it should actually go and invoke this logic, right? But thanks to .NET framework, thanks to the thought given, you know, when they designed this .NET framework, you know, they will actually go and invoke this one, that is with the double data type. Why? Because this is a typical problem of the fragile class. In other words, your parent class keeps on changing and your child classes, which are consumed in a lot of locations, can have issues. So if you now run this, if you see now, even though I'm passing the integer data type, if I do a F11, you can see that he did not go to this handle numerics, which is having the integer data type, but rather he chose to go to the child class because, you know, he thinks that there is probably a fragile class issue. Okay. So next time you come across these kind of scenarios where even though you have proper matching signatures in the parent class, still the roundabout matching signatures of the child classes are invoked, it means it is a protection from the fragile class problem. So many of the developers, you know, they think that this is a defect, but it is more of a by design choice which Microsoft developers have made. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand, you know, how fragile class problems are, you know, solved to a certain extent, you know, by C#.